You should hear my voice through your PC speaker's headset. You can ask questions using the questions panel on the right of your screen. We will answer in the question panel at the end of the presentation by email. Later this week, you will receive link to presentation PowerPoint, PDF, and with narration and data sheets. I'm Angelo Figini. Welcome to this webinar. I'm going to present you a long-term bridge monitoring presentation. And the outline is an introduction, structural monetary benefits, a few examples of a return of an investment, the seven steps methodology, and a few monitoring strategies. Bridge can be built from any of commonly used construction material such as wood, masonry, steel, concrete, and recently also composite. Sorry, it seems there is some problem with the presentation because I can't load. Okay, a particular care is given to the maintenance of bridges with the aim to keep them functional as long as possible. Structural monitoring with fiber optic sensor with a long gauge basis offer the possibility of a global structural monitoring. Let's have a look to the different kind of bridges that we can have. Usually we sort this bridge in five, six main types. We have the beam bridges, horizontal beam supported at each end by piers, arch bridges, R-shaped and have abutments at each end. Cantilever bridges built using cantilever, horizontal beams supported on only one end. Truss bridges composed of connected elements. Cable stay bridges held up by inclined cables. And finally, suspension bridges where the deck is hung below suspension cables on vertical suspenders. The first question regarding talking about structural health monitoring for bridges is the visual inspection enough or it's necessary something more? The most significant limitation of a bridge inspection is that the data collected is based solely upon visual inspection. And furthermore, the visual inspection is highly variable, subjective, and intrinsically unable to detect invisible deterioration, damage, or distress. Then there are many types of damage and deterioration that need to be detected and measured that are beyond the capabilities of vision inspection. Let's have a look to the main benefits in implementing a structural monitoring system. The first benefit is that monitoring discovers deficiencies in time. A few of your structures may present deficiencies which cannot be identified by visual inspection, and in these cases you can save money by taking action before it's too late. The monitoring discovers hidden structural reserves. many structures are in much better condition than you expect. In these cases, monitoring will allow you to increase the safety margins without any intervention. Furthermore, monitoring allows structural management. You can use monitoring data to perform maintenance on demand, optimize the maintenance, repair and replacing of your structures based on reliable and objective data. Monitoring ensures long-term quality. By providing continuous and quantitative data, a monitoring system helps you in assessing the quality of your structure. Again, monitoring increases knowledge. Learning how a structure performs in real or laboratory condition will help you to design better structures for the future. And finally, monitoring increases safety. Having permanent reliable monitoring data from your structure, you can guarantee the safety of the structure and its users. The second question that we have talking about structural health monitoring for bridges is why we need a long-term bridge monitoring. When making plans for a long-term bridge monitoring system, some factors are to be considered. How long do we want to monitor the structure? What type of data do we want? How much data do we want to collect? How will the data be used? Which kind of data management system will be used? And what are the initial costs of this system? To answer the last question, let's see an example of a return on investment. First, regarding new bridges, where the cost of a structural monitoring system is approximately between 0.5 and 3% of the cost of the bridge itself, and the cost of operating the system over 10 years is between 2 and 5% of the initial cost. In this way you can save money because you can discover and repair errors during construction, you can remedy the defects during warranty at no cost. You can reduce cost of future repair and maintenance, and you can also ensure quality by checking. If we are considering bridges candidate for replacement, so we are talking about existing bridges, the cost of replacement without foresee a structural monitoring system, it's 100%. And the cost of a structural monitoring system is approximately 3%. If we install a structural monitoring system, we can, let's say, found that 20% of these bridges are okay. And another 20% need rehabilitation. And the cost of this rehabilitation, let's say that it's approximately 30%. And using a structural monitoring system installed on the bridge, we discovered that only 60% of these bridges need to be replaced. In this case, in this example, the cost of the replacement with the installation of a structural monitoring system is roughly 69%. That means that we can save approximately 30% compared with bridges without structural health monitoring system. Now we'll have a look at the seven steps bridge structural health monitoring methodology. The first step is to identify bridges needing monitoring, then acquire information on probable risks and opportunities from design engineers or owners. Establish expected responses. Step 4, design a structural monitoring system to detect such responses and select appropriate sensors. Step 5, install and calibrate the system. Then acquire and manage the data. And finally, assess and analyze field data. Regarding the first step, identify bridges. New bridges, including innovating aspects, are candidate to be monitored. But also new bridges with unusual associated risks or uncertainties, or bridges that are critical at the network level, or new or existing bridge which is representative of a large population, or of identical or very similar bridges, such as existing bridges with no deficiency or very low rating, candidate for replacement or major refurbishment works. Step number two consists of risk opportunity analysis, and the structural monitoring system designer, the design engineers, and the owner must jointly identify the risks and opportunities associated with the specific structure and their probability. This analysis will lead to a list of possible events and degradation that can possibly affect the bridge, their impact and probability. The result of this step is a list of risks and opportunities that must be addressed by the structural monitoring system. Step number three, identify responses. For each risk and opportunity, associate one or several responses that can be observed directly or indirectly. Roughly quantify the expected responses. And define location and risk to be addressed by inspection and by a structural monitoring system. Step number four, the main step, let me say, is the design of a structured monitoring system. And by selecting appropriate sensor and technologies, consider the required lifetime of structured monitoring system. Consider the available budget, the reliability and redundancy of the sensors, the installation and schedule. Regarding this step, we can have basically three different kind of topology when we integrate strain and deformation sensor. And the simplest one is the simple topology to assess the average strain. The parallel topology that allows to assess the average curvature. And the cross set topology to measure the average shear strain. A typical bridge monitoring layout consists of a couple of parallel sensors installed on the deck of the bridge. And this couple of parallel sensors, strain or deformation sensor, are connected by a passive part to the intermediate connection boxes. And these boxes are linked through extension cables, multi-fiber cables, to a central measurement box, central measurement point, where there are the channel, the reading unit, and the channel switch. This central measurement point, it's an independent system, and it's connected to a user PC in the office or by wire or wireless connection. What are the requirements of a long-term bridge structural monitoring system? First of all, the system must be able to record slow changes over time due to loading and environmental effects. Then the wall record bridge temperature and the individual sensor temperatures. The residential system must be robust enough and able to operate in a self-sufficient manner. The data logger must automatically collect data from sensors, and application software must post-process raw data and summarize the results. Finally, the system must be remotely accessible from the office. The step number five is the installation and calibration of the system, and it consists of installation and testing of all components, verify correct installation in accordance to the specifications, commissioning, and if required, site acceptance test. Step number six is the data and acquisition management that consists where we must foresee database management system with documentation of intervention. A data storage must be in a standard database format, so it's easily possible to review historical data. The last step is the data assessment and analysis. By analyzing the responses of the breach, the engineer will be able to identify if any of the foreseen risks and degradation have materialized and if any of the opportunities are confirmed. It consists also in established procedure to respond to detection of any degradation, and the analysis of the data might prompt for further investigation, including also visual inspection, testing or installation of additional sensors. And it's also possible to set alerts, warning, and periodic reports. Now we will talking about few monitoring strategy, especially for bridges. And let me say that each monitoring project present its peculiarities, and although it's possible to standardize most elements of monitoring system, each application is unique in the way they are combined. Anyway, however, it's possible to classify the monitoring components according to few main categories, such as scale, parameters, periodicity, response, data collection, and phases. Regarding the scale, we can talking about local scale, where the performance is analyzed looking at the local properties of the construction materials, but it's not the case of a structural monitoring system, of course. Member scale, where a number of selected critical members are observed for their global behavior. Global scale, the structure is observed from the point of view of the overall performance and response. And network scale, the monitoring of several structures belonging to an infrastructure system allows the owner to make decisions at the system level. Regarding parameters, basically there are mechanical parameters such as strain, displacement, curvature, rotation, physical, material temperature, humidity, chemical parameters, concentration, chlorine, sulfate, and so on, environmental, air temperature, humidity, solar radiation, wind, and action, vehicle loads, forces, and so on. The primary monitoring parameters, basically, direct monitoring, basically are the average strain, the shear strain, rotation and inclination, temperature, and temperature gradient. The final monitoring aim can often be achieved by indirect monitoring, for example, by data analysis of results obtained from primary monitored parameters. And these indirectly determined parameters obtained by using appropriate algorithms are the following: curvature, the deformed shape of the deck, for instance, pressures and forces, acceleration, pre-stress losses, relative and absolute displacement, and humidity. There are also other additional monitor parameters, such as the testing of the bridge, crack monitoring, forces in the strands during pre-stressing, and pre-stress losses in cable and or strands, for instance, in the cable stay bridge or in the suspended bridge. Now another question is why we should use fiber optic sensor to monitor those parameters, and the reason are There are several reasons. First of all, because the small size and light weight, because the high sensitivity of fiber optic sensor, because the multifunctionality, great variety in the measurable parameters, because there are several topologies, there is not just the local point, single point sensor, but also the multiplexed and the distributed topologies. Then the fiber optic sensors are insensitive to external perturbations such as electromagnetic fields, radio frequency, lightning strikes, and etc. Then also because the durability and reliability in demanding environments, because they no need electrical power, because they allow long distance remote monitoring, and they are also compatible with data transmission networking, also existing, already existing networking. Regarding the monitoring strategy, the periodicity, we can have a periodic measurement, manual measurement at the predefined intervals, for example, once every 3 months, semi-continuous automatic measurements over predefined time periods, for example, one measure per hour for 1 week every 3 months, or continuous permanent automatic measurement, for example, every hour. Talking about the bridge response, we have basically two different kind of response. Static, in case we are talking about the measurement of slowly varying parameters, or dynamic, measurement of vibration and other dynamic responses. Regarding data collection in the monitoring strategy, it's possible to have a periodic sensor, in this case sensor installed but not measured, and they are activated only when necessary. Manual data collection, the measurements are performed by an operator on site. Online, all data is permanently available online, and real-time data collection. In this case, data is collected online and analyzed immediately to allow immediate feedback to the owners and our users. Regarding the phases, we can perform a monitoring system, monitoring acquisition during construction, during the testing of the bridge, in service, during refurbishment, for instance, enlargement or strengthening, or rarely also during the dismantle of the bridge. In conclusion, to summarize, long-term bridge monitoring can provide quantitative data from network and bridge level management, and this could contribute to a much greater level of reliability and utility of data necessary for asset management. Bridge safety, especially during extreme events, is enhanced by measurement and monitoring of critical bridge components. Enhanced safety, reliability, and efficient maintenance can result from improved incident detection and assessment. Furthermore, it's really very important to develop a partially automated data analysis methodologies, translating the raw measurement data into a high-level information that can be used for decision-making purposes. A global bridge health and performance assessment must and can only be accomplished using quantitative measurement methods. Subjective assessment simply is not adequate to meet these needs. The outlook regarding structural health monitoring are that in the next future we can expect that bridge monitoring system become mainstream. Furthermore, fiber optic sensor will increase significantly the market share in the global sensor market. And it's also expected that new types of sensor will also appear. But the main development will be in the consolidation, large-scale production, and cost reduction of existing technologies. It's easy to predict that structural monitoring in general will see a more widespread application to many types of structure, not only bridges, that are currently not monitored or are only visually inspected. In this last slide, you can have a look at some selected reference projects regarding bridge monitoring worldwide, performed by the RockTest Group in the last decade. Thank you for your attention, and if you have any question, please don't hesitate to contact me at my email address or directly right now. Thank you.